Hello everyone. Today we'll be building a variable power supply, and I just wanted to take a moment here to show you my very first power supply. It's a variable 0 to 18 volt DC, and we have the old pot here. We have the analog voltmeter, and it's broken from the front. And here we have the template for the new one, and I've already Dremeled and drilled the portions that I'm going to set my parts in, and I'll be going over that throughout the video. So let's start with putting in the output terminals, then moving on to the switch and the pot for the new variable power supply. And lastly, the fuse holder. So now you have all the parts into the box and it's fairly secure. So now you have an idea as how much space you have, so you know where to put your transformer and other electrical parts. You have your switch here, you got the fuse holder. So let's move on to adding the electrical cord. So now that you've got the cord in, you want to try to make it as sturdy as possible. I have a strain relief there, and what I do to add to it, to the strength of it, I tie it like this. Now, you can add your board to make sure everything's going to line up, like the holes up here to the LM317 heat sinks. And I'm going to start here with the capacitors. So this is the schematic we're going to be using throughout the video. And I just want to point out a few things. We have two separate DC voltages. For the first is the variable 1.25 to 27.29 volts DC. And we have a set 5.16 volts DC. I want to point out as well that it's a transformer to two bridges in parallel, but you could also do this with one bridge. That way you don't have to add an extra component. But for this how-to, I personally wanted to use two bridges just so I could minimize confusion as to what goes where. But there is better ways of doing this, of course. This is just how I did it. This is how I suggested you do it. So I'll explain how to get the fuse current and everything as we go along. So this is the equation for V out, and I got it from the LM317's data sheet, and I recommend you look at it if you want more information on the component. I recommend you look at any component's data sheet if you have questions. So the equation is V out equals voltage reference multiplied by 1 plus R2 divided by R1. Now I want to make a quick note that R2 is referring to the resistor from adjust to ground, and R1 is the resistor from V out to adjust. Here are the values plugged in. Now, the voltage reference according to the data sheet is 1.25 volts. And for my variable DC supply, it's 5,000 over 240 ohms, while my set DC voltage is 750 over 240 ohms. Next, you do the math, and it comes out to 20.83. etc., etc., and 3.125. Now you add 1 to each. So our answers are 27.29 for our variable DC voltage and 5.16 for our set DC voltage. And when you're calculating what voltage you want, just remember that the transformer secondary should be close to what you want your highest output value in DC to be. So we're going to start with the 3300 microfarad capacitor. It does have polarity, so be careful when you're putting it on the board. As you can see, I laid these capacitors down so that way they won't touch anything at the top of the box. And this way, they fit perfectly when you put the board inside of it. So let's move on to the next one. Now you're going to add a 0.1 microfarad capacitor. And this one's going to go in parallel with the capacitor we just put. And as you can see here, you could just put it a few centimeters away from the other one. So now we're going to add the bridge rectifier. And this one's going to go in parallel with the two capacitors. Make sure they line up correctly and the polarities are right. Next, you want to put the voltage regulator, the LM317. Now, the way I put mine was to line up with the holes I drilled in my box. So, you want to make sure that they're perfectly aligned, because once you put that board in, it's going to be pretty difficult to pull up and or push down the components, and you don't want to damage them like that. Next, we're going to add protection diodes. This way, the capacitors, when they discharge, they don't short out the voltage regulator. So I just wanted to make a quick note that the LM317 pinouts are adjust on left, V out in the middle, and V in on the right. So now we have the diodes on, and make sure they're going in the right direction. And we'll be connecting it to the bridge later. Now we're going to add the 240 ohm resistor going from V out to adjust. And I used a half watt resistor. A fourth watt resistor will be fine. I just happen to have a 240 ohm laying around in half watt. Next, we'll be adding the 10 microfarad capacitor. And this one is polarized, so careful to put the positive and the negative in the right places when you solder it in. And this will be going from the adjust to the negative. So next, we'll be adding a 750 ohm resistor to our set DC voltage. And I'm going to be using the left side as my set DC voltage. And I do want you to add wires for the right side. I want you to add 2 7-inch wires so that we can add the potentiometer later. But we're going to move on to the 1 microfarad capacitor right before the output terminals, or the voltmeter and ammeter. And these are polarized, so be careful when you add them. So now you want to connect the positive to the VN of the LM317 and the negative to the negative side of the circuit. So as you can see here, I stuck the pin terminals of the AC from the bridge rectifiers up through the board and connected negative and positive. And we'll be using the pins later. So to make things easier, we're going to add terminals from our 1 microfarad capacitors, and they're going to come out from the board. This way, when we solder them later, it'll be easier to find them. So you can see here, I put the pins as high as I could. So next, we're going to be putting the bridges in parallel, but we won't be connecting the actual transformer just yet. Now, depending on which bridge you choose, I chose the one on the right since my transformer is the closest there. I want you to put the bridges in parallel, which I did. I soldered them in the back here. Next, I'm going to go back now that we have almost everything done and put in the 5k ohm potentiometer. So I want to make a quick note here. And I want you to make sure you don't solder the leads to the potentiometer on the sides only, because that makes it a 5k ohm resistor, and that means it's a set power supply, not a variable one. So what you want to do is you want to pick the middle terminal for sure and one of the side ones. This will make it a 0 to 5k ohm, and it will make it a variable power supply. The only reason it matters depending on which side it is because, for example, me, I want it to be at 0 ohms on the left, completely turned to the left, so that way the voltage is at 1.25. If you turn it all the way to the right, it'll be at the 27 volts. So, use discretion. So next we're going to be adding thermal paste to our LM317s, and we're going to be putting on our heat sinks with our heat sink kit. Once it's on there, it should look something like this. And you want to make sure you're careful of these bolts because they will get hot. So next, we're going to take the ground from the three prong, and we're going to take the center tap of the transformer, and we're going to put them to the transformer itself. So you take the ground and the center tap, put it near the screw, and this way it'll be an added safety to the casing of the transformer. Next, we're going to add the switch from either side of the three prong. And I'm going to choose the live side to the switch. So next, from the switch, we'll be going to the fuse holder to the primary side of the transformer. Either wire on the primary side of the transformer is fine. And you want to run your cables as clear as possible to the eye so you know where they're at. So next I'll be showing you how to calculate the rating of the fuse. This is the formula, and it is 2 times the supplyable current from the transformer over N, which is the primary voltage over the secondary voltage, both in AC, of course. So for this particular fuse of mine, it's going to be 2 times 1 amp over N, which is 120 volts AC divided by 24 volts AC, which comes out to 2 amps divided by 5, which turns out to be 0.4 amps, or better known as 400 milliamps. Now, let me just add the fuse. Because without the fuse, it's an incomplete circuit. So when we turn it on, we don't want a disappointing no-show. Now you don't have to tighten it too hard. Just tight enough. So next, we're going to complete the circuit on the primary side from three prong to the transformer. And now that we have everything there, make sure you shrink tube everything, make sure no connections are bare and they could possibly touch. And this way we can move on to the next portion of our power supply. Now we're going to connect the secondary to the bridges, which are already in parallel. So now we're going to solder the secondary part of the transformer to the prongs that we had earlier from our bridges. So that way, once you solder the wires to one bridge, it's already in parallel with the other. So next we'll be adding our voltmeter and ammeter, and we'll be connecting our output terminals from our variable power supply. I just want to mention that whether the voltmeter and ammeter are digital or not, the voltmeter needs to be in parallel with the 1 microfarad capacitor, and the ammeter needs to be in series with either output terminal. So this is my schematic for my voltmeter and ammeter. The blue wire is going to the negative side of the output terminal, the red's going to the positive side of the output terminal, and the black is the negative input from the bridge rectifier. From the negative side of our variable DC voltage to the black wire, to the blue wire, to the negative output terminal seen here. Then, from the positive side of our variable DC voltage, from our red of our voltmeter and ammeter, they come together and they go to the positive terminal seen here. So now we're going to be working on our set DC voltage, and the output's going to go to powering the digital voltmeter and ammeter. And the schematic's pretty straightforward. Positive goes to the positive of the output, and the negative goes to the negative of the output. And here it is, wired in. Positive and negative, both going to the connector, which is already set. So you really just watch the polarities, because you can't really mess this one up. So now we get to see the fruits of our labor And from the old, we come to the new. And I have to say, this looks pretty damn good. So let's plug it in and see what the display looks like. And we turn it on and it works. Let me turn off the lights so you can get a better look at the LED display. So we got voltage in red and amperage in blue. And we have from 1.46 volts DC to 28.2 volts. It's not bad. It's pretty close to our calculated. It's more than enough voltage that I'll ever need. So let's test this thing. Let's put it at 12 volts. And let's see if we can power a light here. I'm going to use a festoon bulb from a car. And we have to make sure that the power supply can output the voltage it's displayed without dropping. And there it is. It works. The shining glimmer of hope. So I just want to raise it a little. And there's our current reading. We got 50 milliamps at 12.3 volts. And note the heat coming off the bolts from the voltage regulators. You don't want them to get too hot. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you build a variable power supply with a digital voltmeter and ammeter. Enjoy.